Our top story, team coverage on two Stop the Violence initiatives being launched here on the Central Coast.
They range from actually fasting to fighting crime with a surge in manpower and weapons for law enforcement. Again, team coverage, beginning with Action News reporter Felix Cortez. Felix Cortez is live in our newsroom, and we begin with Brittany Nielsen, who's live in Salinas for us. Brittany?
Dan, Mayor Dennis Donohue led the city in a fast back in July. Now he's doing it again, but this time he's asking the entire state to join him. The fast for peace going statewide.
We will be asking all the other United Methodist churches in the state to participate. We will be speaking to the bishops of Northern California and Southern California.
The mayor certainly would like support from the police chiefs in the state, and I will certainly do everything I can to try to get that for them.
I think the other mayors will probably support this.
A fast in July considered successful by many based on participation numbers.
We estimated at least 5,000, at least, but I really think it was more than that.
And homicides dropped. With 15 in the first 6 months of the year, the fast fell at the beginning of a six-week period of calm and no deaths.
Well, the violence actually did subside for a number of weeks.
Now Mayor Dennis Donohue is asking the governor's office to issue a statewide proclamation for Fasting for Peace Week. He's asking a 13-city coalition to join Salinas, cities like San Jose, San Francisco, and Oakland. And he'll also be asking Monterey County mayors to get on board early next month.
To cut back and just to have one meal a day as a symbolic gesture for peace, I think, is an effort that's worth supporting. And I will definitely support it, and I'll ask my council to support it.
Some local pastors support the effort wholeheartedly.
We're going statewide with this, statewide, because we know that there are many other cities that are also struggling with violence in their community.
The mayor says to view this more as a spiritual fast rather than a religious fast. It's more about community involvement, he says, and he says he will measure the success of this fast by how many people get involved. Dan.
All right, we'll see. Thanks very much, Brittany.